So guys, welcome to the Kiss Matrix. Guys, in this video we are going to see the introduction of Google Colab. Okay, so Google Colab is a web service which is provided by many companies right now. Okay, so everyone is working right now on Google Colab because Google Colab provides a free GPU, right? Free GPU, which is not majorly present in our local systems because it is so much expensive, even everyone cannot buy it, right? So I'm just going to open my Colab right now. Okay, I'm just opening my Colab right now, or I can just close it and open it again. Just write Google Colab. Okay, you will see a first link. Welcome to the collaboratory. You can Google research. Okay, it is provided by Google. Just click on this part and you will see a function over there. Google Colab is majorly used for deep learning purposes. Okay, or machine learning purposes. I can click on new notebook. Okay, I can click on new notebook. So these files will not be available in your systems, okay, in your directory, because I have created all these files. I have worked a lot. So I will just click on new notebook. I will just click on new notebook right now. It will try to create a new notebook for me. Now you can see a loading, right? You can see a loading over there, which is happening inside this. So it will try to give me a notebook, just like same procedure like a Jupyter notebook, okay? Same procedure like Jupyter notebook. Now there are little some steps which you need to know. Okay, first of all, before doing anything, you need to connect. Okay, you need to click on connect. So it will try to connect a CPU which is provided by Google, not our local system GPU or CPU. Okay, now there are two things, right? There are two things. You can connect to CPU, you can connect to GPU, or you can connect to TPU. Okay, so GPU stands for graphical user interface. Now you can see over there it is initializing till now. Let's wait for that. Okay, now if you want to check, okay, what type of systems they have given you, okay, Google have given you, what kind of systems they have allocated for your notebook, just click on runtime, just click on change runtime, right? So hardware accelerator is option. Okay, hardware accelerator is an option, and you need to select, okay, what kind of hardware you want. Suppose you want, if you will try to click on none, so it will try to give you a normal CPU, okay, central processing unit. Now if you want to set a GPU, just click on save. Okay, just click on save. So automatic it will try to allocate you a GPU. So it is saying that, okay, you need to manage your sessions. Maybe in my system some notebooks are working back in your backend. Okay, now just click on reconnect. Now it will try to reallocate to your notebook to a GPU. Now if you want to see, okay, what type of system they have provided you, you can need to just write NVIDIA, okay, NVIDIA-SMI. You can run this command. It will try to tell you, okay, what kind of GPU they have given you. So they have given you a CUDA version of 11.2. okay, your GPU name is nothing but you can try to see over there. It should be there. NVIDIA SMI 495.4. Okay, so this type of things you can see what kind of GPU they have provided you. Tesla K80. Okay, they have provided you. So Tesla is also a powerful GPU. They also have to prefer. Now, what kind of RAM and disk they will provide you? You can see RAM, 12 GB of RAM they have provided you, and disk is your 78.19 GB. Okay, it is your, you can say, local storage that you can try to use. Now there is one more thing. So in our local system we have something known as local storage, like in our hard disk, right? But in Google Colab, your Google Colab is a web, right, web application. So they cannot connect with your local storage. So what you can do, you can try to use your drive. You can try to use your drive, which is known as your Google Drive, right? So you will get an option of drive as well. Just click on this drive. You can try to use this type of things. You can try to use this type of things for as a storage for your Google Colab. Now the question is that how you can connect to your Colab and drive. How can make a connection, right? You can just click on this file option and you can click on this. Okay, this, which is known as mount drive. It means we are ready to connect your drive with Google Colab. So that you can also easily use all the contents which is available inside this. Okay, I'm just going to connect it. Now it will ask that, okay, are you, please give me permission so that I can connect with your drive. So just click on connect to drive. Now see, mounting drive, it means it is trying to connect your drive with your collab. Now just click on refresh. Now see, drive function is available. Okay, drive folder will get available. It means it is all content which is present inside your drive. Fine. Now the question is that can you implement Python over there? Yes, exactly. It is made for Python only. Okay. Or just write over there like print command, you can try to use print hello world. So whatever you want to do, you can do it normally as your Jupyter notebook. Okay. It can open your py file as well. It can connect with your .ipynb file as well, whatever you want to give. You can also change your notebook names like in this way. You can give session on collab. Okay, you can try to give this name as well. So it will try to change the file name. Okay guys, you can do anything, whatever you want. You can import NumPy as well. You can import pandas as well. Okay, you can do anything over here. Pandas as pd, or you can write pd.read_csv, whatever you want to do, you can try to do it over there. Okay, or you can try to use numpy function as well, np.sqrt. I suppose of 3 I can try to calculate, right? So again, numpy as np, I want to do it. Now see, this is a square root of my 3, right? Now this is all how you can try to connect with your Google Collabs and your Drive. Okay, so I hope you like that. I hope you have understood all the things regarding Collab and Drives. So guys, this is all about this video. Thank you so much.